Hello, I'm Ad-Granth, junior retired lecturer in hermetology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. He came in 1469 and preached gospel for 150 years through five more lives to perfection. Each one had his own, you know, field of specialization. Still the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our father came himself and sorted them with sword power. He established the last two communities, one of apostles and one of the soldiers of God, to fight for righteousness. And here I am doing exposition of St. Luke 2, verse 22 to 40. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call SATGURU Jesus. According to St. Luke 2, verse 22 to 40. Now this is our Supernatural Father, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And what about our natural father? He is Yahweh, Brahma, and Khuda. Khuda is different from Allah. It's not the same. Such things are not known to common man. It's only known to those who are capable of intuition, can think logically themselves. Then they will find it. Gospel of living father is not for the dead in letters people, as the university professors are, but the living in Holy Spirit, which is common sense. So use common sense and you will get everything you want to know. And read books, you get nothing, zero. When the days were completed for their purification according to the law of Moses, Mary and Joseph took Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord Yahweh, the Heavenly Father of Jesus, or Yeshua. Yeshua stands for two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam, the firstborn of Yahweh. So they took him to present him to their Father, you know, the Father of Jesus. That was the outer court of the temple where they had the rituals, ritual killing of the turtle and other things, you know, presented. So, just as it is written in the law of the Lord Yahweh, or everything that you see with two naked eyes, all belong to Yahweh, nature. He is the Lord of the nature. Every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the consecrated, oh dear me, to the Lord Yahweh of nature, and to offer the sacrifice of a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord Yahweh. The Lord Yahweh's scripture can be written down in ink on paper, but not of our supernatural father. That get written over here, the living tablet of heart, not on the dead paper. This is a dead as compared with the living inside. Oh Lord Yahweh. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man, this man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. So he had the Holy Spirit, you know, and with the Holy Spirit you are the, you know what God knows, because you are his son. And that's why Jesus went in the temple and said, he is the Messiah. He was before David, before so and so. Then they were laughing at him. How can you be before David? You are just 34 years old. So these things, you know, are spiritual. Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Messiah of the Lord, of the Lord Yahweh, Elohim. Now Elohim is the Lord of the Lord, as you can see here. I show you. This is the menorah, which has 7 candles. These are 3 here and 3 here are the Holy Son, Holy Father, and Holy Ghost. It go like this. Sorry. Holy Son, Holy Father, and Holy Ghost near to Elohim. And here are evil, you know. So you have evil Son, evil Father, and evil ghost, hypocrites, temple high priest was here. So there are 2 triangles left. That's why David's cross is upside down. One representing one, the other one another. Evil and good. This is, we are called karma of the works. Works lead to reincarnation. Grace leads to resurrection, as in Lazarus it was shown. So this is a Christianity in a nutshell. The 12 laborers of Jesus had nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel. There were 7 in the name of John the Baptist and 5 in the name of Christ Jesus. So here is the royal kingdom of God, and this is the kingdom of heaven. And this is the royal kingdom of God within our heart. This is outside, and this is within our heart, inside. So this is my book, and it is on Google. So the middle candle, you know, is the Lord, is Elohim. Elohim is the Lord of Yahweh. So, if you can see, people, when they worship in synagogue, to them, Yahweh is the Lord. And Elohim is the Lord of the Lord, Lord of Yahweh. Because without him, the creation of Yahweh is dead. He is the one who supplies soul, or infused soul into our body. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit upon him, it had been, it had been revealed to him by Holy Spirit, very Spirit of God, that he should not see death before he had seen, before he had seen the Messiah of the Lord Yahweh, Elohim. He is the son of Elohim, Messiah. And Jesus was son of Yahweh. That's why his name was Yeshua. He came in the Spirit with the Holy Spirit, is the discerning Spirit of God, extraordinary sense, into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child, Jesus, to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, he took him into his arms and blessed God, saying, "Now, master, you may let your servant go in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which is in Christ Jesus." The rabbi teaches the moral law. Moral law lead to works, and works give you new birth. Next birth is depend upon your works. Karmi ave kapda, we say. And the salvation is by the grace of our Father, and that is what the Son of Elohim is, omnipotent ambassador of Elohim. So he came to deliver people of the bond of the rabbis, rituals and other things, to set us free to be the sons of the Most High Elohim, so that we become royal priests. Royal priests are Christ. They are not Christians of the book, as you find them in churches. Which you prepared in sight of all the people, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and glory for your people Israel. Light for Gentiles, because people in India, Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, Christ Nanak, he came among the people of Khatri tribe. And Khatri tribe people were very, like Judah tribe people, they were very religious people and very well versed in the holy books, letters of the holy books. They read holy books day and night without understanding. So he came among them. And as Jesus was maltreated by people of Judah tribe, the most, and so were Nanak maltreated by the people of Khatri tribe the most. So they hated him, and they won't listen to him. But people who were like us, from the farming tribe and other people, and we listened to Nanak. And Khatri were less than 1% who became Sikh. And we Jat people, we were about 70%, the greatest number among them. There's a history behind it, why that is in my book, if you want to be interested. And this book will give you the more information. Hello? Hello? And glory for your people Israel. The child's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him. And Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, surrogate mother, not his mother, because she was having the seed of Yahweh. So she was the surrogate mother of Jesus. And Joseph was foster father. No dear, where is that? Were amazed at what was said about him, and Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his surrogate mother, "Behold, this child is determined for the fall and rise of many in Israel." Because these temple priests, they were stooges of the Roman. So they were inclusion with each other, Roman, like Church of England and the Queen. They are in hand in hand. So that's why the Church of England, they say that soldiers of Queen who died in World War I, World War II, they glorified God. So what type of God was that? Who was glorified by killing people, not serving? Salvation Army people say they die for king and country, which is right. So they have no common sense, you know. Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel and to be sign that will be contradicted. And you yourself sword will pierce, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. Contradicted, this is quite important. In Moses' law, if somebody hit your one cheek, then you hit him on the other. So if somebody hit you, you hit him back, you know. Tit for tat is the Moses' law. In Jesus, if somebody hit you, we present the other. We are not tit for tat. So that is the contradiction. So that's in Jesus, we present the other cheek. We don't hate anyone, because in everyone is the light of our supernatural Father, which is soul, is present in everyone. So why should we, if we hate the person, we hating the person whose soul is inside it, Elohim. So that is the contradiction, you know. So that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. That is the heart, you know, because Christianity is of heart and not of the book. Book is a tit for tat. If somebody hit you, that's what the laws are, you know. That if somebody killed, as in among the Mohammedans, then you have to pay blood money and so, tit for tat. There were also a prophetess. There is no prophetess, you know. They are saints. Anna was a saint, you know. Because prophets are those who are whipmasters for the rabbis. And this Anna and Simeon, they were not whipmasters, they were saints, both of them. And that's why they possessed the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, which Jesus possessed also. The daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher, she was advanced in years, having lived 7 years with her husband after her marriage, and then a widow until she was 84. Remember, 7 has a special meaning. The 7th, remember Jesus said, what happened when she married the 7th husband? There's neither giving nor taking, because the 7th was the middle candle of menorah, which stands for Elohim. When you are one with Elohim, then there's neither giving nor taking. They become saint. So this woman was saint, not prophetess. The most of these people, you know, they don't know the difference between a saint and a prophet, or the kingdom of heaven and the royal kingdom of God, which is inside. Kingdom of heaven is outside in law and order. Most people have no idea what that two are. She never left the temple, but worshiped night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very time, she gave thanks to God, Elohim, and spoke about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Jerusalem. Because this is a Christ comes to, he has a large winnowing shovel. As John the Baptist said, you know, I'm baptizing in water. The one coming after me is the one who has the winnowing shovel. He will separate the sons of man against sons of Satan. Sons of Satan, yeah. That means saints and the sons of Satan. Give thanks to the Elohim and spoke about the child to all who were waiting the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord Yahweh of nature, the Heavenly Father of Jesus, they returned to Galilee to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, strong because his father, Yahweh, is strong, is the Lord of the nature, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God, Elohim, was upon him. So he had the favor of, you know, when you preach gospel, don't be frightened, because we have the favor of our supernatural father, Elohim. If we did not have favor, then we can't preach gospel. So gospel is given to those who have been favored by our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. So when you have gospel, don't be frightened. That's why Jesus said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus, eating the flesh of Jesus means what came out of the mouth of Jesus, you should eat it with your ears. That's why Jesus said, those who have ears, let them hear. Hear twice upon people. So take it to your heart, digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning. Then from your own heart comes the gospel. When you preach it to the people, you preach it thorough understanding with the mastery, as the woman, as the Samaritan woman said, when Christ comes, he will tell us everything. So that is what we do in Jesus. We are royal priest. We are the brethren of Jesus. He is not our Lord, he is our brother. We are one father. So that's why the child became strong, and wisdom and the favor of God was upon him. God is Elohim, Allah Parbrahm. So he was the son of the supernatural father, the Christ within his heart. And not this one. This was the son of Yahweh. That's why his name was Yeshua. So Jesus died on the cross, not Christ. Christ is never born, and he never dies, because it's a spiritual self and not the physical self that is born and dies.